Hi, this is Barbara, and today I'm going to show you how to make a digital binder for free in just 4 easy steps. I was trying to make it 5 steps, but LiveBinders is so easy I could only come up with 4. So LiveBinders will let you create up to 5 digital binders completely for free. And whether you're organizing documents for clients or field trip information for parents or handouts from your presentation, it's all just going to look better in a digital binder. Let me show you a couple of examples before we build our first binder. So I was doing a presentation on how to create investor presentations. And this is my binder that I did for that. So instead of at the end of my presentation doing this and giving people a long list of links, I put everything together in this nice binder. And we automatically generate a table of contents for you. This is optional. You can have it or not. But it's organized into tabs and subtabs. And here is my presentation, actually in this subtab, in all its detail. I did a little cheat sheet as well. And then I backed it up with a bunch of articles and these are from websites, and then there's videos in here. All this in one nice little package for everybody. And you can see the subtabs are on the left. You can have the tabs on the top or on the right. That's all up to you. So let's look at another binder. So this is a real estate investment company, and they put together investment packages all in LiveBinders for their clients. And so any information that you need on that investment is right here in this LiveBinder. So it's just a really nice way for them to package information for their clients. And most of this is uploaded documents in their case. So let's get started with those 4 steps. The first step is to sign up. So go here in the upper right corner and click on sign up. And you can either sign up with your Google account or sign up with an email. Once you sign in, you'll see a binder that we've put on your shelf for you already. So that will help you get started. You can start editing it. So I'm going to mouse over and click edit. So we are all ready to step 2. We're going to start adding content to our binder. So in this first tab in the binder, you will see a video and some instructions that will help you get started. It's pretty simple though, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. I'm going to go to the second tab here and just start adding some content. So I click on the Add Content button, and let's say I wanted to upload a file. Choose a file. I'm going to make this binder picture all about my dog. Click on upload. Here's my uploaded file sitting right there in the tab. I can change the tab name just by clicking and typing. Go to another tab and let's add a video. So I'm going to search for a video of my dog, which I happen to know is on YouTube. So all I do is I look for the video and then I just click on it. And that gets inserted automatically into the tab right there. So then I can go back here and delete this first tab. And now I've got the start of a binder all about my dog. So let's go to step 3. Let's make the binder pretty. I'm going to click on Binder Settings, and here I'm going to give it a new name. I can give it a description. I can put tags in there. I can even change the name of the author that appears on the binder if I want to. I can change the tab colors. So let's change the tab color here. Let's do this nice bright pink or purple. I don't know which one that is. I can change the tab layout. I can have the tabs on the side, tabs on the left or the right. I like my tabs on the left, so I'm going to do that. And then I can select a binder cover. Now I can upload a new binder cover, I can use a video for my binder cover, or I can just use the picture that I've already uploaded into this tab. And there you go, picture of my dog on the binder cover. Save this. Now you'll notice, even though I selected tabs on the side, you're not going to see that when you're in the editor. But if I view and hit play, I'm going to see my nice new binder here. And it's got my little cover image up in the corner and my tabs. So this brings us to our fourth and final step. How do you share a binder? Well, a binder is just a link in your browser, but there are lots of options for sharing. Click on Options, Share. And if this is a private binder, which it is right now, you need to add an access key if you want people to see your private binder. But you can also make it public, and then nobody needs an access key. I can send it out via email. I can embed the binder icon in my website. I can share it on Facebook, Twitter, Google, or even in Google Classroom. So this is the link. It's right here, and you just copy paste that link to send it to somebody. There's also an option to embed binders in websites. You can actually create a shelf of binders and embed those in websites as well. So lots of ways to share. So I love what Sarah said about LiveBinders, that it actually allowed her to reclaim hours of work in her day. That's an awesome quote. I hope that helps you get started building your first digital binder. Please let me know in the comments if you need more information or if you would like another video on some other aspect of LiveBinders.